Hey everybody, it's Brenda Adelman, and it's all opposite. It's so weird here. I actually wanted to share with you about storytelling because I did a survey a while ago and I got a lot of answers and I thought a lot of questions from people, like what they were struggling with telling their story. And I thought, well, why don't I just make some short videos and help you? So today I just have my Google form up, and of course I shut it. I wanted to address the fact that, here it is, where is it? I had a lot of different questions I put out, and most people said, I had like 100 people respond, that they are really struggling with how to present their stories in a way that is compelling. Okay, so let me see if I can get back on there. Okay. So I just want to give you a few tips, maybe one to three tips. How can you be compelling? Now, most of these people that I surveyed were entrepreneurs, not really my performer clients. So I'm going to talk about entrepreneurs and how you can be compelling. There's a few ways. The main way is to be freaking authentic, okay? And I don't know why I got angry about that. I think it's because so much of this world, everyone is like living on the surface and they've got their mask on and everything is perfect and or it's not perfect. And we're so multi-layered, right? We're so multi-layered. I don't know about you, but I appreciate authentic and real. I want to know there's a real person behind the perfect picture. You know, we all have good days, we have bad days. God knows with me, I have good hair days, bad hair days, and things like that. But I want to know there's a real person there. Who has had a life, right? So I want you to be authentic. So I'll just focus on that. So let me give you some tips on how to be authentic because I've worked with a lot of clients now, and what happens is, and I've worked with people who are very authentic people, right? Because I work with a lot of healers and people who have come to their business because they've been through big life events that have kind of torn them up, and now they're getting to the other side or on the other side. And a lot of people are on the other side because they've compartmentalized, right? And so they don't really know how to tell their story in an authentic way. They almost like they know how to tell the hero story or how strong they are, but they don't really know how to tell the before story or how devastated they were or how it was really hard growing up in, you know, one person, more than one person, an abusive family or in a family where, you know, it might not have been as dramatic as like my story or some of my other clients' stories, but it was something where they just never felt loved. And that is enough of a story, right? Sometimes I have clients who they think they don't have a story to tell because they didn't live through something dramatic, but life is made up of drama and comedy. Hopefully comedy too for you guys. But it's sometimes it's those small moments that you live through where you're alone in your room when you're growing up and you just feel like nobody cares, nobody loves you, and you're on your own or you don't understand why the adults aren't taking care of you, right? But yet it's not a dramatic story like mine, right? My father killed my mother. That's pretty fucking dramatic, okay? People don't listen to me because of that story. They come to my shows and they listen because I say how I got through it. But I don't go to, oh, and I forgave him, Pollyanna. Oh, I forgave him and then it was all good, or I just went to forgiveness because I knew that that's the right thing to do. No, that is not what happened. And that's not interesting to listen to because that doesn't help you know what the hell to do when you go through something dramatic like that. But that said, there are moments that probably were skipped over in my life, in my storytelling, because I have something dramatic that I talk about that inspires other people to say, oh, she lived through that and was able to forgive and able to trust again and trust herself and love herself. Well, maybe I could go on. But there are moments that I almost had to look at after going through all that where I could look at, well, what about those quieter times in my house growing up? You know, there are stories there to share. So I want you to look at your life and say, well, you are enough, and whatever you live through is enough. And you know, if you're an entrepreneur, you have an opportunity to really show who you are. Be you. Be all you. And you can't be all you if you got a pile of crap on top of your story, like a story about the story. And that's the kind of stuff that I teach. I'm doing a free webinar on Thursday at 10 a.m. to go more deeply into this, to, you know, because I can't talk about everything here, although I'm planning to do a lot more Facebook Lives and videos. I'm going to take the results I got from some of the surveys I did and just do short videos and give you tips, especially if I hear from you and you say, oh man, that was helpful. I'll do more of these. I'm so passionate about helping people look at their story, reflect on their story, be authentic, change their lives and change the lives of the people around them because they're able to be authentic. And that what I will say about that too is you got to watch who you're authentic with, right? Because sometimes you can be authentic with your business friends. You can be authentic with your clients. You can be authentic with your colleagues. You can be authentic with certain people, and then other people are really scared of emotions. They're really scared of that, and you know, it might not be right for you to share super authentically and vulnerably with someone who might close you down at first. If you learn the tools to take care of yourself and love yourself and know you're enough, then you can share with anybody. You know, if you want to talk about something that you think might help somebody, that's great. But you do want to emotionally be strong so that when you share and share with people who might not get it, you know, that you can not ever have to go into defensiveness and stuff like that. I have a really interesting story that I'll shut this down with. I was interviewed for a Blog Talk radio show. Was it a podcast? I think it was a Blog Talk radio show last year. And I guess the woman didn't do her research. And it was about forgiveness. But she didn't do her research. I don't know what happened. She must have had an assistant or something. So do your research, people. She didn't realize that I talk very openly about my story. It's part of my healing, and it's part of the healing for the thousands and thousands of people that I have presented my story for, right? Women prisoners, youth at risk, in addition to theater festivals and conferences and things like that. And so I said what my story was to lead up to how I learned how to forgive, and she got really defensive, and she was offensive, and she was like, well, you're airing your family's secrets. Is that right? It was something like that. It was funny after the fact. I even had a client that was listening, and it was like, wow, she obviously hasn't healed her stuff. I didn't have to go into defensiveness because I've done so much work, and I just went on to say, well, actually, I think family secrets are what hurt people. You know, you don't talk about what's happened, and it's in the closet, then it keeps happening, right? That happens with incest. It happens with a lot of things. People don't talk about stuff, and then that's how there's more damage that's done. So I believe you really want to talk about things, and you want to be healed when you're talking about it. So yes, Thursday at 10 a.m., I'm doing a workshop where I'm going to give a free webinar, 10 a.m. Pacific time, that I'm going, I don't have the link. I'll put the link up, but I'm going to teach you three steps to be able to tell your story in an authentic way and in a way that's compelling, because you're giving of yourself. You're vulnerable, but you're also strong, so you're not feeling like drained, okay? So I will post that link. If you're interested, you have any questions, you want to tell me what your struggle is around storytelling, I will definitely do more videos and post them and subscribe to my channel. And that's it for now. Have a fantastic day and make your story a good one.